Hi, my name's Jason. This video is dedicated to your inner engineer, architect, landscape designer. If you have any of that in you and you need to work with circles, you're going to need to work out the area or the circumference of a circle. Or if you deal with cylinders, the volume of that cylinder. This video talks about the maths behind all that, including powers and pi. And I'm going to show you how to do all of that in Excel. Here we go. I'm going to do two things here. I'm going to work out the area and circumference of a circle. Secondly, I'm going to work out the volume of a cylinder. Now, both of these require the use of pi, that's mathematical pi, which has a special value of 3.142 and a few thousand other digits there. But instead of typing in a fixed value of 3.14 and all the rest, I'm going to use the pi function for accuracy. So, first of all, if you just plug in a radius of, say, 5, now, radius, of course, is the distance between the center of the circle and the edge of the circle. The area of a circle, then, is pi r squared. So the value of pi times the radius squared. So first of all, we type in equals pi, open bracket, close bracket. And if I have to press enter there, there's the value of pi. If you were to expand the number of decimal places there, it would just keep on going almost forever. So we're going to expand this formula, so equals pi. Multiplied by the radius to the power of 2. Now the little symbol there I've used for power is shift and 6 on the keyboard, and it's the symbol followed by the 2 that says it's squared. You can't just put the symbol in, that wouldn't work. It's the symbol followed by the 2 that says squared. If it was the symbol followed by a 3, that would mean cubed, as in the figure times the figure times the figure. So let's just press enter there, and the area of this circle is 78.5 whatever units squared. The circumference of a circle, the formula for that is 2 pi r. So 2 times the value of pi times the radius. So that's a bit simpler. We just say equals 2 multiplied by pi, open bracket, close bracket, multiplied by the radius. And that is the circumference of the circle. That's the distance of the edge of the circle. Let's move on to the cylinder. So again, I'm going to plug in a couple of values here, maybe 5 again for the radius, maybe 10 for the depth or the height. The formula to work out the volume of a cylinder is basically the area of the circle times the height or the depth. So the first bit's actually the same, pi r squared times the height or the depth. So again, I'm going to start with equals pi, open bracket, close bracket, multiplied by the radius value to the power of 2. The radius squared, multiplied by the depth or the height. Press enter. Now this, of course, is going to be in cubic measurements, so cubic centimeters, cubic meters, whatever, and that's the volume of a cylinder. Of course, when you set things up like this, you can change these values at any point, and your formula down here will change. So that's a super quick rundown of how to work with circles and how to work with cylinders.
Booyah!